Hi, it's Christy at the Bureau with the latest update on Tropical Low 28U, which is approaching the northwest coast of Western Australia and may develop into a tropical cyclone later this evening. Let's start with our satellite picture. We can see these areas of deep convection, these red and black areas surrounding that low pressure system as it sits about 315 kilometres north of Derby. Now through today, it has been moving in an east to southeasterly direction, but as we go through the afternoon and evening, it is expected to turn and move in a more south to southeasterly direction. It is moving quite slowly and may stay over those warm waters long enough to develop into a Category 1 tropical cyclone later this evening. Now, if it does do that, it will be named Tropical Cyclone Diane. But whether or not it is a tropical cyclone, it's expected to make landfall sometime during this evening or early tomorrow morning, most likely somewhere between Curie Bay and Cape Levique. Now, as that system approaches the coast, we do have this tropical cyclone warning area shown in orange here. Now, that is for damaging wind gusts. We're talking winds up to 100 kilometres an hour. Now, that's enough to bring down trees and power lines and cause damage to properties. We're also talking about heavy rainfall that could cause flash flooding. Rainfall totals of 70 to 100 millimetres over a 6-hour period, maybe even up to 150 millimetres in that period. Now, we are expecting the system to move inland tomorrow and rapidly weaken back into a low pressure system. It's likely to continue to move southwards through Saturday and then on Sunday tend more south to southeasterly as it moves into the interior of Western Australia. Looking at the rainfall a little bit more closely, we can see those heavy falls starting to develop along the coastal areas later today and into the overnight period. We're also seeing those damaging wind gusts wrapping around the low as it approaches the coast. Now, we are expecting those gale force winds up to 100 kilometre an hour wind gusts, most likely between Mitchell Plateau and Beagle Bay, but could be as far east as Troughton Island, particularly if the system takes a slightly more easterly track. As we go into Saturday, the system is expected to move inland, dragging that heavy rainfall with it. Now, the heaviest rainfall is likely to be close to the centre of the low. So the locations that get that heavy rainfall will depend very much on the exact track that the low takes. But we are expecting widespread heavy rain and thunderstorms through northern parts of Western Australia and even over the border into southwestern Northern Territory. So we have a severe weather warning for heavy rainfall. Now that's this yellow area, remembering of course that these areas closer to the coast were covered by that orange tropical cyclone warning. Now that was for damaging winds, heavy rainfall and elevated tides. However, this is for heavy rainfall. Now that's heavy rainfall that could cause flash flooding. Rainfall totals once again of up to 70 to 100, maybe even 150 millimetres over 6 hours. Rainfall totals over 24 hours of 100 to 150 millimetres, maybe even some areas seeing rainfall totals over 24 hours of 250 millimetres. So let's take a look at the rainfall across the whole event. Now this is looking at rainfall between midday Friday through to the end of Sunday. We can see that rain spreading inland as the low moves southwards. Widespread falls of 50 to 150 millimetres, that's these orange and pink areas. But we can also see a few purple areas that suggests the risk of some places seeing totals across the entire event of 200 to 300 millimetres. And with that sort of rainfall, we are expecting flood impacts. So we have issued flood watches for the Sandy, the Tanami and the Western Desert districts. Now, these are expecting rivers, creeks and streams to rise in response to all that rainfall and cause significant impacts, including overland inundation. So with this system, we are expecting to see damaging wind gusts. Now again, that's strong enough to bring down trees and power lines and cause damage to properties. However, the biggest concern with this particular system is the heavy rain and flooding, and in particular, its impact on roads and the isolation of communities. So if you're traveling through this area, make sure you check conditions before you leave, and of course, never drive through floodwaters. And that's it for this weather update. Make sure you stay up to date with the latest warnings on the Bureau's website and app as this system develops through the course of the day. Follow all advice from your local emergency services and please stay safe.